A lot of cancer research of late has focused on the genetics of cancer and how this may be adapted to personalized medicine. Looking back, you know, there's a lot of metabolic changes that occur in cancer as well, and many of these are actually dictated by those genetics. It's been known for the last 100 years that cancer cells metabolize nutrients differently than normal cells. And despite knowing this for a long time, it's really something that's never been fully understood. Looking at the basic biology of how cancer cells metabolize their nutrients to build new cells will teach us about new targets and new ways to go after better cancer therapies. It turns out that all cancer cells take up a lot of glucose. Everybody knows this. It's the basis for PET scanning that is used in the clinic to diagnose and stage cancer. Our research has really focused of late on a couple of different areas. One is looking at a specific isoform of a glycolytic enzyme called pyruvate kinase. Pyruvate kinase has a form that's expressed during development of an embryo, and then most adult tissues in our body switch to a completely other form of this enzyme. Well, it turns out all cancer cells switch back to the form that was there during embryonic development. And so we've been looking at trying to understand this pyruvate kinase regulation, and we found some really surprising things. The idea that an enzyme that metabolizes glucose is actually turned off despite all this increased glucose uptake is a paradox. From a therapeutic standpoint, it really raises the possibility that perhaps small molecules might be able to be used to activate this enzyme and restore the normal state that's seen in normal cells. And we've had a fantastic collaboration with a group at the NIH and have developed some of these molecules. We are very excited right now to be testing these in various models of cancer to really determine, is this something that could be a therapeutic in the clinic? So I hope in the next 10 years our lab can contribute to some fundamental understanding of how cell metabolism is regulated and how these processes apply to cancer. And I think it would be fantastic along the way if we're lucky enough to have some of that knowledge translated into better therapies for at least some patients.